One of the lessons that I will never forget from a former seminary formator were these words from him: proper time, proper place, and proper purpose. At ano po ang ibig niyang sabihin sa mga salitang iyon? Kung oras ng aral, naroroon ka dapat sa tamang oras ng pag-aaral at marahil sa lugar ng pag-aaralan at maging seryoso sa pag-aaral. Hindi oras ng aral, nasa laruan at naglalaro. Something to that effect. But what is meaningful is the last phrase, proper purpose, tamang layunin. And my dear brothers and sisters, this is something that we might need to learn, rediscover, and maybe regain that proper acknowledgement of proper purpose of the many things that we have today in life. Our readings may be so short, but they have a lot to share with us. James left a strong remark towards the end. For one who knows the right thing to do and does not do it, it is a sin. While Jesus gave a strong reminder to all of us, there is no one who performs a mighty deed in my name who can at the same time speak ill of me. They are all teaching us to embrace proper purpose. It is the grace that we might need to ask today, my dear brothers and sisters, to see the proper purpose of ourselves, of what we have, of the faith that we believe, on the things that we are doing, and even our own mission of bringing the Lord to others. Those who drive out demons in the name of Jesus knew very well the purpose of the name of Christ, and that is why they succeeded. Kaya siguro sila nagtagumpay dahil alam nila kung ano ang layunin at ano ang dapat gawin sa pangalan ni Jesus. But if they lost the sense of purpose, I think they will lose the fight. And again, my dear brothers and sisters, it is for us to see. You have the talent, you have the energy, and you have the time, and many others. May mga layunin po yan, bakit iyan ang nasa ating. Let us know its purpose so that we can have a blessed outcome after. We have faith, then let us see its purpose. That is why we will keep on inspiring others. We will do our little thing of evangelization, teach others to pray, and so on. Because when we begin to see purpose, to see proper purpose, we won't waste it. We might not be so different from it, but then we will value it and see it as a blessing. My dear brothers and sisters, whatever God is giving us, there is always a side-by-side purpose for it. Even purposes are sacred. And let us value these purposes so that we can see it deeply as a grace of God and as God's blessings for us.